The government's proposal to increase the number of justices of the two appellate courts was grounded on the need to curb backlog at the two courts so as to improve service delivery at those levels.
The object of the bill is to give effect to Articles 130 and 134 of the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda by prescribing additional number of justices of the Supreme Court and justices of the Court of Appeal. The bill further empowers Parliament to increase both the number of justices of the Supreme Court and justices of the Court of Appeal.
However, the Parliamentary Committee on Legal and Parliamentary Affairs did not find merit in government's justification to vary the number of judges, arguing that it can't solve the backlog if performance of the jurists is not enhanced.
The committee has examined the bill and presentations made on the matter and is of the considered opinion that the proposal to increase the number of justices of the Supreme Court from the current 11 to 21 be rejected. In arriving at this decision, the committee is of the opinion that instead of appointing additional justices of the Supreme Court, case backlog experienced at the Supreme Court can be dealt with through the following measures. A, appointment of justices at the Supreme Court in acting capacity under Article 142(2) of the Constitution.
The Supreme Court, headed by the Chief Justice Alphonse Owinyi-Dolo, is the highest court of judicature in Uganda. The committee rather proposed that the Chief Justice invokes Article 41 of the Constitution to appoint justices temporarily to deal with the case backlog in the court. The report read by the committee chairperson, Robina Rakojo, the woman member of Parliament for Gomba West, considered that the legal and financial implication of the proposed amendment was not well conceptualized by the drafters of the bill.
The committee is aware that whereas government issued a certificate of financial implications, the certificate doesn't take into account the additional costs required to make additional justices effective in executing their mandates. The committee is aware that a justice of the Supreme Court is entitled to certain facilities, including bodyguards, research officers, house helps, and other persons who facilitate the justices to deliver on his or her mandate. These persons are paid from the Consolidated Fund.
Lawmakers wondered that although the government is seeking more judges, it has failed to appoint the 11 judges prescribed for the Supreme Court and the 15 judges of the Court of Appeal under the Judicature Act.
As the Judicature Amendment Act in 2008 increased the number of justices of the Supreme Court to 11, but since then up to now, they have never appointed the 11. There are only 9 that have been appointed. So appoint up to 11.
The Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs, Norbert Mao, explained that the appointments were delayed by the operations of the Judicial Service Commission, which he said is now well-constituted and functional.
The spirit of give and take is healthy because I am the one dealing with the people who are waiting for their appeal cases to be heard. And the practical matter I'm dealing with is the health of many of the Court of Appeal judges and the backlog which ties them down to carry out more research and to write judgment, which means the panels cannot be constituted at the same time. I ask that members add 5 to the 30 proposed by the committee. I beg to move.
I put a question that the House adopts the report of the Committee of the Whole House. Those in favor stand the control and nay. The ayes have it.
Last week, Chief Registrar Sarah Langa told the committee that the number of pending cases at the Supreme Court stands at 792, with 353 accruing from case backlog. Langa added that at the appellate courts, they have 9,888 pending cases and a backlog of 5,882. At the divisions, she cited a total of 24,759 pending cases and a backlog of 9,186 cases. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.